Okay, guys, let's continue our lesson. As you know, before you already read 11.02, right? As we know, we now already know that three types of nuclear radiation. They are alpha, beta, and gamma. Okay, hopefully you can take a note, copy this into your notebook. Okay, we will learn together. Catat ya guys. Okay. Now read. A radioisotope is an isotope of an element that has an unstable, sorry ini salah, unstable nucleus and can undergo radioactive decay by emitting alpha, beta, and gamma. Oke. Duh, gimana nih? Udah, copy. So basically, radioisotope is an unstable nucleus. So to make it stable, they have to decay alpha, beta, and gamma. What is alpha, beta, and gamma? We will learn their properties right now. Ready? Okay, so what is alpha, beta, and gamma? Alpha, beta, and gamma. What is alpha, beta, gamma? And then can you find the relative charge of alpha, beta, and gamma? And then can you find the relative mass of alpha, beta, and gamma? Okay. So alpha, as you know, is helium. Memorize ya guys, helium. Beta is electron. Gamma is electromagnetic wave. Electromagnetic wave. Okay. Tinggalan helium, which is has 2 proton and 2 neutrons. Relative charge. Helium has 2 proton, so positive 2. Beta is electron, right? So negative 1. Gamma is electromagnetic wave. So the charge of electromagnetic wave, which is zero. Oke, bisa ikutin? Continue now. The mass, the relative mass of alpha. Four. Beta is 1 over 1800. And then gamma is zero. Because as we know, gamma is electromagnetic wave. So the mass of gamma equals to zero. And then alpha and beta, if we compare, yeah, alpha is 4, beta is 1 over 1800, which is alpha is greater than beta. Or we can say that alpha is the greatest among alpha, beta, and gamma. Clear until here? Continue, ya. Next. Then we will learn about ionizing radiation. Coba. What is ionizing radiation? I think there is on your book deh about ionizing. 1102. I don't know the page, but still in the first page, 11.02. Ionizing radiation. Ions are charged atom, right? And then atom becomes ion when they lose or gain electron. So at atom, oh sorry. So atom will becomes ion when lose or gains electron, right? Yeah, easy lah. This is similar with chemistry, yeah. And then on your physics textbook, nuclear radiation can remove electrons from atom. So it has an ionizing effect. Clear? Underline, yeah, on your highlight on your physics textbook also. Definition of ionizing. And then, second paragraph, if a gas becomes ionized, it will conduct an electric current. Jadi, if gas becomes ionized, it will conduct electric current. Saya. Clear about ionizing? Move on. Nah, now Miss Iki will give you some illustration about alpha, beta, gamma. Yeah. This is the illustration, guys. Let's say ini Miss Iki have paper here, a sheet of paper, and then I have aluminium here. Aluminium, and then I have lead over here. Then, ini blue, this is the alpha. And then alpha, stop. Oh, salah. Sorry. Alpha stopped by paper. Okay. And then, after that, what happened with aluminium? Aluminium, gimana? Can penetrate paper, but stopped by alpha. I mean beta. Beta can passes through the paper, can penetrate the paper, sorry, and then stopped by a few millimeter of aluminium. What happened with gamma? Ayo, gamma can penetrate paper, penetrate aluminium, and also can penetrate lead actually. But when gamma penetrate lead, the intensity is reduced. Yeah, intensity is reduced. Clear about this? Memorize, yeah. Alpha can stop by a sheet of paper, beta penetrate paper, but stop by a few millimeter of aluminium, and then gamma can penetrate paper, aluminium, even lead. Ok, Okay, but the intensity of gamma will reduce when penetrate light. That's it. Memorize. Bisa? Easy ya? Okay, now Miss Kiki will give you again the table. The properties of alpha, beta, and gamma. Oh my god. Okay, before we before we learn about charge, mass, and what is alpha, beta, gamma. Okay, and then this one, the penetrating of alpha, beta, and gamma when passes paper, alpha, and lead. Then now, Miss Kiki will give you summary. Based on the ionizing effect. And then penetrating. And then behavior in magnetic field. Magnetic and electric field. Alpha, aduh, beta, this one is gamma. Yuk. Alpha, beta, and gamma. Yuk. What happened with ionizing effect? Penetrating dulu deh, penetrating. Which one is very penetrating? Alpha, beta, or gamma. Very penetrating. Based on this, which one is the most penetrating? Of course, siapa? Of course, very penetrating is gamma. Right? So, we can say that energy effect, gamma is very penetrating. Explanationnya because gamma can penetrate light. And then alpha, which one is the weakest? Alpha, beta, or gamma? Alpha, right? So we can say that alpha is not very penetrating. But beta can say that more penetrating than alpha. Gitu ya. Reasonnya maybe ya. Ini absorbed by few centimeter paper. A few. Bisa nih, susah tuh, centimeter of paper. This one, a few millimeter of aluminium. Okay. This one apa? Can be stopped by lead. Yeah. Oh my god, ini Miss Kiki change ya. I salah table. Ayo rubah ya, ini penetrating dulu dah. Kali ini salah masukin ke table. Penetrating effect. Ini ionizing. Yeah. ionizing effect. How is it? Ayo. Which one is strong ionized? Alpha, beta, or gamma? Which one is the weakest? The strongest, of course, alpha. Why, miss? Ayo. Ionizing effect is the strongest. Why? Aduh. Susah amat sih nulis begini. Why? Alpha is the strongest. Because, yeah. From our information before, what is ionizing sih? Tadi ionizing, lose electron and gains electron. Okay, item becomes ion when lose or gains electron. Okay, based on the charge of alpha, beta, gamma. Lihat, alpha to proton to neutron. Okay, alpha has positive 2, beta has negative 1. So which one is, which one have the greatest charge? Alpha, beta, or gamma? Of course, alpha. So based on that, that's why alpha has greatest ionizing effect compared to beta and gamma. So which one is very weak, the weakest, based on this? Yeah. Based on this, that the charge of gamma is zero. Of course, apa? Gamma is the weakest. Bisa ya? So gamma is very weak. Clear ya? So this one weak lah. So start from alpha is the strongest, and then beta, and then gamma. Clear? Okay, next. Bisa ya? Bisa, right? Okay. Magnetic effect, magnetic and electric field. What happens when alpha, beta, and gamma passes magnetic and electric field? Okay. Logically, lihat. Alpha is, apa tuh? Alpha is electromagnetic wave. Lihat. Alpha is electromagnetic wave. Alright? So, and then, lihat lagi charge-nya, zero. Alright? So, what does that mean? So, when alpha passes passes magnetic field and electric field, when gamma passes magnetic and electric field, what happened with gamma? Yo? Gamma has no charge, so undeflected. Clear? So, gamma is undeflected. Ngerti nggak? What is the reason? Because tadi apa? Has no charge, boleh. Because what else? Because maybe apa? Gamma is apa? Electromagnetic wave. That's the reason. Clear ya? Okay, what happened with alpha? Of course, deflect. What happened with beta? Of course, deflect. Clear? We will learn about this, about this one later on, after this. Miski will explain everything about this. Bisa, guys? Copy, ya? Tuh. Miski give you 1 minute, cepat. Bisa ya? Dah, continue. Jangan lama-lama. Durasi. Next. Nah, tadi Miss Gigi said I'm gonna explain about magnetic and electric field. This one ya. So, effect of electric field. Duh, tulisan masih jelek. Misalnya, effect of electric field. Oke, sekarang. Electric field, as you know, dia like this. Masih put ini positif, 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 positif. Positive plate, negative. Okay, this is electric field. What happen when gamma, ini gamma ya, passes the electric field? Gamma undeflected. This one. It passes, you know, it undeflected. So just go straight. Bisa? Then, what happen with beta? As we know, beta, alpha dulu deh. Alpha? Alpha positif atau negatif? Lupa. Si. Alpha. Tuh. Positif atau negatif? Alpha is positive, right? Tuh. Beta is negatif. Beta is electron. Alpha is helium. Right? Bisa? Beta. Alpha, remember ya, alpha is positive, beta is negative. So what happen if you have positively plate here? What happen to alpha? Alpha dulu deh. Warna biru. What happen with alpha? Misalkan meski saat sini. Ayo, salah. Yo, guys, what happen with alpha? Alpha will, apa? Alpha attracted to negatively plate because alpha is positively charged. Gambar aja. Like. Jadi gini. Nah, like that. This is alpha. Bisa? Ini supposedly ini nempel ya. Wait. Miski ulang. Susah nih pakai ini. Tuh, like that, ya. This is alpha. Yang nggak bingung ini gamma. Nah, what happen with beta now? Beta is electron, right? So beta attract to positively charge. Bisa? Misiki beta. Start from here also. This is beta. Clear, guys? Bisa? Bisa ya, meski repeat, alpha is undeflected because alpha is electromagnetic wave or alpha, kok alpha sih dari meski ngomong sorry salah. What happened with gamma? Gamma is undeflected because gamma is electromagnetic wave or gamma has no charge. Okay, alpha attracted to negatively plate because alpha is positively charged. Of course dong, positive and negative attracted, right? And then beta, gimana? Beta attracted to positively plate. Bisa? Clear ya? Gampang gitu. Now, can you see the difference between alpha and beta? Coba. Gamma kan undeflected. Alpha and beta deflected. But, did you realize something guys? Here, that Miss Kiki draw this one. Alpha. And beta with different deflection. Did you notice? Which one has greater deflection? Beta or alpha? Ayo. Ini sering keluar ya, pas paper ya. Ayo. Beta. Gimana? Greater deflection than alpha. Kenapa? Ayo. Alpha is smaller deflection. Kenapa yo? Beta greater deflection dan alpha because kenapa? Beta greater, ayo. Kenapa? Coba kamu assume, you assume. Let's say ada yang fat person sama yang slim person. Kalau dia lari, which one is the fastest? The slimmer one atau the fatter one? Of course the slimmer one, right? Nah, that's why beta greater deflection because, back lagi nih, biar you ingat. Because beta, lihat, the mass of beta is only berapa? Lihat, 1 over 1800, which is beta slimmer, which is beta smaller mass than alpha. That's why beta has greater deflection. Ngerti? Ngerti nggak? Ini sering keluar loh, pas paper. Ini because greater mass. Bisa ya? Logic ya? Logic. Beta greater deflection means, oh yeah, because beta is slimmer. Ya dong? Because beta smaller mass. That's why greater deflection. Alpha, smaller deflection. Kenapa? Because small alpha is heaviest. Is the heaviest. Ya dong? Greater mass. That's why smaller deflection. Clear? Duh, already. How many minutes this one ya? Wow. Bisa gak? Easy peasy ya? Bisa? Next, ini yang susah. Udah ya? Effect of electric field. Now, effect of magnetic field ini yang susah. Dikit. Effect of magnetic. Gimana ya, Mas Gigi gambarnya gini dia. Ini like that ya guys. Let's say lah ini north, this is south. Oke, ini agak susah dikit. Nanti you can ask this, after this video kan, Mas Gigi and Mr. Edward will online in Zoom. Okay, you can ask about this again, yeah, because this is a bit difficult. Okay, now, what happened with gamma? Ayo, gamma easy peasy, gamma undeflectedness. Okay, what happened with alpha? Ayo, do you remember guys, using Fleming's left hand rule? We're gonna use Fleming's left hand rule here. Fleming's left hand rule, remember? FBI, FBI, force, field, current. In here we have field, north to south. Okay, we need to find the force. We need to find this one. What happened with current, miss? We don't have current here. Current, okay, we can apa? Assuming as an alpha. Kenapa, miss? Because current is positive, right? Alpha also is positive, right? So by using Fleming's left hand rule, ayo together. Using Fleming's left hand rule, guys. Yuk, left hand rule ya, left hand rule. FBI. Okay. The first finger itu north to south. You gak bisa lihat I, gak apa-apa. You coba aja dulu ya. And then, after that, we have... apa dulu nih? Alpha. Okay, we have alpha here. Nih, alpha. Alpha here. Okay, like that. From left to right. FBI. And then... alpha will deflected kemana guys? FBI, north to south. Ayo. Mana? Ini gambar aja bener gak sih? Bingung ya? Ini agak susah sih nih. Itu north to southnya into the page, out of the page ya guys. So direction of the magnetic field. Mesti gituin dulu nih, kamu nanti bingung. Nih. Field line-nya like that. Tuh. Into the page. visa into the page. And then, car-nya to the right. So what happen? Alpha-nya will go gimana? Upwards. Temu enggak? Bisa ya. Hopefully bisa deh. Nanti kita itu lagi. Salah. Duh, meski susah gambar ya nih. Meski susah gambar ya. Alphanya upwards ya itu disini ya. What happened with beta? Beta opposite. Because kan alpha is positive, beta is electron right negative. So ini downwards. Bisa. Pasti ini agak bingung. Lagi deh, Miss Kiki. Ini kemana dia pergi? Dia pergi kemana? Lagi Miss Kiki pakai contoh yang gampang deh. Bentar. Tadi agak susah. Ayo pakai contoh yang ini, biar juga gampang. Nih. Nah, ini lebih gampang. Ini north, this is south. Ayo, berarti direction of magnetic field lines-nya gimana guys? North to south, like that. Bisa? Bisa ya, downwards ya. Masih hapus lagi biar gak bingung. Then, as usual. This is gamma, right? What happened with alpha? Yo, alpha dulu. Ayo, what happened with alpha? Nih, pakai yang blue. North to south together, downwards. And then current-nya, middle finger-nya, you, kemana? From left to right. Betul? Berarti gimana this one? Like that ya, into the page. Ini alpha. Beta, how is it? Opposite, right? Berarti apa? Out of the page. Remember which one has greater deflection, alpha or beta? Beta, because beta smaller ya, berarti ini greater deflection. Same like that, but like that. Bisa. Hopefully you pada bisa ya. Ini agak susah sih emang. What else ya? Udah deh. Itu dulu deh. Nanti nambah mabok. Right? Now, coba answer this question, guys. This one already ya. Sorry. Nah, yuk. Answer this one. Copy on your notebook. Ini number one ya, ini masih ada number two. Better yuk buat daripada ikut tinggalin yuk screenshot. Bisa. Finish. Is that that hard, right? Let's answer together. Aduh, how to answer ya? Ah, you just listen to me ya. Okay, alpha particles deflected towards top of page. Okay, they already decided alpha towards top of page. And then with small deflection. What happened with beta? Bentar. Beta is deflected. If alpha already top of page, so beta apa? Bottom, because alpha and beta kan apa? Opposite charge. And then the deflection large or small, of course, large deflection. Because beta is, tadi apa? Slimmer, small mass. What happened with gamma? Gamma, of course, not deflected. Clear ya? Next, number two. This one. Yeah, answer. Ah, bisa nih. Yuk. Yuk. Together. Mass of neutron. Ayo. Coba proton one unit. Charge-nya plus one. Location-nya in the nucleus nih. Remember ya guys ya. In the nucleus. Ya, neutron. Begitu ya, neutron berapa? One unit. Charge? Zero. Location? Also in nucleus. Aduh. Oke, elektron. Gimana tadi? 1 over 1000. 800, then charge negative 1, and then in orbit. Tell. Aduh. Okay, next. Which of the particles in the table make up an alpha particles? Of course, apa? Proton and neutron. On the same scale, state the mass of an alpha particles. Mass of alpha? 4 units. Right? And then? Charge? Positive 2. Easy, right? Copy ya, on your notebook ya. So easy, right? Okay, how many more minutes, guys, do we have? Coba. Tadi. Wow. Udah 42 minutes. Bisa ya? Now, answer the question 1102. Number 1 to number 4. I don't know the page because your book and Miss Kiki's book is different. Pokoknya 11.02 nuclear radiation 1 in the second page-nya. Question number 1 to number 4. Okay? For this question, you have to answer on your exercise book, right? Then after this lesson, as usual, please take a photo, your notebook and your exercise book, and then send. Okay, Miss Kiki. Okay, send to Miss Kiki, yeah. Okay, then after this we will meet in the Zoom. Okay, bye bye guys.